Young Nikela John lived a full life for the brief time that she was with us, but during that time, she more than made her presence felt. Such was the spirit and desire of this young lady that many feel she has left an indelible mark.
Princess, guardian angel, God gave you to us for a minute, but our fond memories of you will last a lifetime. God will never take anyone away until they have taught us what we need to know. Thank you, Jesus, for blessing us with Nikela John. Thank you for welcoming her into heaven, where she will now look over us, together with our other guardian angels. Thank you, Jesus, for giving Nikela her time on earth, for allowing her to remind us all about undying and infinite love.
They turned out in their numbers to say one final farewell to one who has gone too soon in young Nikela John, the daughter of former national footballer Stern John. The church in Santa Rosa in Arima served as the meeting place where those gathered included national coach Dennis Lawrence and assistant Saul Campbell, among others, including past and present footballers who knew the family and the loving spirit that was Nikela.
Nikela fought against her condition, refusing to let it define her. She aspired to become her best self, trying football in her early days, then becoming more interested in teaching, business, law, and mastering the kitchen like her mom. From St. Joseph RSC, she went to Holy Name Convent and then to UWE Roy Tech, where she was pursuing her associate degree in business management. Her intelligence, wit, determination, and sense of humor forged friendships and memories way beyond her years.
Her good friend, speaking in glowing terms of her enduring spirit, was testament to the fun-loving and full life Nikela lived, while touching all who came into contact with her in a very profound way, leading the pastor to talk about empathy and how okay it was to feel pain and grief when thinking of this young spirit. He also related the story of her buying a rose and being told of the questions giving a young lady a rose posed.
The question for me: are we, as a people of God, as a body of believers, we who even now find it difficult to trust in God at this time, are we living a life that testifies to the resurrection of our Lord? And I say this not to judge anybody, or not to condemn anyone. Our sister has done well for the short time she has spent with us, and we have to give God thanks.
Gone but by no means forgotten, young Nikela, time was cut short, but her legacy looks like it will be around for many, many more years in the hearts and minds of all who met her.